Another great sponsor for Madison County School Sports Television is Madison HVAC. Visit them at madisonhvacr.com. You want to know school sports in Madison County? Then you need to visit madisoncountyschoolsports.com. Everything sports in Madison County. That's madisoncountyschoolsports.com. Visit us now. Welcome, everyone, to the 2013 Madison Central High School Men's Basketball Awards Banquet. Sponsored by Richmond Car and Truck Center, doing business the RCTC way, where quality and integrity are standard equipment. Located on Atwood Drive. State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goebel in Richmond. Luxury Pet Service in Richmond. Premier Rehab right here in Richmond. Renfro's Paint and Collision in Richmond and Berea. Davenport Custom Guitars, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, Richmond Tourism, First Gear, Row Signs, Berea Online, and WKYT.com. Another great sponsor for Madison County School Sports Television is Madison HVAC. Visit them at madisonhvacr.com.
Well, good afternoon. It certainly is very special to be here, and I want to again express to everyone just how much I appreciate everything that these two teams have done this year. And I want to share a couple of thoughts that I've had over the last year, because last year whenever we came together at about this time, maybe there was a sense of unfinished business. As we left, we had last year's team had gone as far as win-wise to a place that no team had gone before. And so as I started reflecting on that a little bit over the course of this run, I realized that as I looked at last year's team versus this year's team, and not to say anything one against one or the other, but there were some things there that didn't come together as a team. And I think the success in this year's basketball team is maybe the case where you had a group of young men and they believed in each other and they believed in their coaches. And you know, I think in some cases, really our boys especially saw their teammates as their brothers. It was like a family. And they saw their coaches really as their fathers. And I love all of our boys on our team. And I'm going to tell you that some of the guys don't even really have that special of a relationship with their family as they do with their brothers and with their coaches as their fathers. But I'm going to tell you, when you get a group of people together, whether it's players, coaches, parents, boosters, administrators, whoever, and they start putting their own goals below the team, we put the team above everything else, some special things can happen. And I think that everybody got to see how special that was when everyone comes together as a team. But you know what that takes? That does take belief, that takes trust, and that takes commitment when things don't look so good. I remember the Hoptown game, and we were down, and our fans were doubting whether we would even win that game. Heck, I was doubting we were going to win that game. At the beginning of the third quarter, I get a text from one of the coaches at Boyle County who's won state championships in the football, and the text was very simple: you have to believe. And at that moment, you know, I'm almost embarrassed to tell you that I showed my doubt, because I'd actually seen this team at the King of the Bluegrass tournament whenever they were down and the odds were against them, and I was almost embarrassed to show my doubt. However, the boys were able to make us all know that we have to believe. No different with our cheer squad. Do you know that almost all 29 of these girls have been national champions? Almost every one of the 29 have been a national champion. Tori, if I'm not mistaken, is a four-time national champion. That's crazy for me to think about. And every girl on this cheer team is either a national champion or an in-state champion. So this is truly a day of champions for both our boys basketball team and our girls cheerleading teams. And they've been, between these two teams, they have been champions all over the state and the nation. Our basketball and cheer teams have gone north and south, east and west. And if you don't think that's the case, I want you to listen to this. The boys team have competed in Marshall County. That's about as far west as you can go in Kentucky. And they've been champions in West Virginia. They've been all over the state playing and touring. I saw them at the King of the Bluegrass Tournament in Louisville. I saw them visiting lawmakers in Frankfort. Our cheer team started out the year in South Carolina, and they've competed in Cincinnati, in Lexington twice, in Bowling Green twice, and Orlando. And they've truly covered the land, north to south, east and west. And that's not to mention the whirlwind tour of Daniel Boone, Cottle Middle, Clark Moores, Waco, Kirksville, Kit Carson, whichever, Mayfield, Madison Middle, I'm forgetting somebody, I'm certain, but that was a whirlwind tour. That was so amazing that it was so exciting that whenever we were leaving Whitehall to go to Kit Carson, you know how short that road is? Every one of the kids were asleep on the bus on that short ride. I can't begin to tell you how many hours our teams have put in traveling to showcase the best that Madison Central has to offer. And if you think traveling and competing takes a lot of time, imagine the amount of time that it takes to coach these teams. I know as a former coach how much it takes to prepare a team just not for the competition, but just for the practice. For today's practice takes a lot of time. And that doesn't even mention the stress that goes with managing things like getting the buses together or arranging meals, getting physical forms in, counting heads when they're getting on the buses. And our coaches have spent hours, which add up to months, away from their families, all for our kids' sake. Coach Fritz, as you know, has a very young family. Coach Spicer, she has a fiance. 10 minutes ago, she's telling me that she's arranging her wedding during dead period so that she can spend time with our girls. Coach Roberts, he did hours of training for driving that bus this summer. Alan and Karen have been amazingly special because they did all of this, not only just with their teams, they had to sacrifice their time away from a Division I basketball daughter on the MCHS girls basketball team. That's almost hard to imagine. So for all of that, coaches, I hope everyone will help me and show their appreciation for everything for this team and for these coaches. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. That's a much deserved standing ovation. This time we want to bring up Mr. Gary Ball from the Scholastic Ball Report for a special presentation. Gary, you had the honor of calling the championship game as well, didn't you? I thought so.
Thank you all for having me to your celebration. I'm probably the most unbiased person you'll have here today because I did not attend Madison Central High School. I attended Boone County, but don't hold that against me. We did not ever win a state championship when I was at Boone County. And we had some awfully good football, basketball, and baseball teams, but never won a state championship. Like these cheerleaders never won a national championship. So I wanted to definitely be here and let you know that on behalf of the Scholastic Ball Report, I've got a few remarks I want to make, but Coach Feldhaus and I have gotten to know each other over the years through his family. Allie, his daughter over there, interned on my TV show a few years ago. She was a cheerleader here at Madison Central. nice young lady doing great things at Western, pursuing broadcasting. I see Mr. Park out here. He and I are very close friends through the 11th Region Tournament. Every year we talk and have a great time over there at the 11th Region. First off, I want to thank Coach Feldhaus for inviting me to this very special celebration. This year, the reason I wanted to come is because high school sports is something that I've loved for a long time and something I've broadcast, radio and TV. I got to call the state tournament on the radio this year for the KHSAA for the Sweet 16 Radio Network. And when they asked me before the tournament, is there any one team that you want to specifically call in the tournament? And immediately I said, I'd love to be able to call Madison Central. That's not a given. They allow you to do that. The KHSAA assigns you who you're going to broadcast, what games you're going to do. They assign the talent, who they hire for that, and all that, as Sean knows, who does a great job here with all your games. He and I have become friends over the years, too. He does a super job. But broadcasting the high school tournament is quite an honor. And I was able to call all your games on the radio network this year for the Sweet 16, and I got to do your state. If you watched that state championship on TV, that was me and Brian Milan. We had the opportunity to do that for WKYT. Brian does a super job, and what a great game that was. To me, your team epitomized high school sports. That's why I wanted to attend this banquet. I'm not a big banquet person per se, no disrespect. But everybody says, well, you didn't go to this banquet, you didn't do that. But when I saw what Coach Feldhaus and this team meant to high school sports and to this community, I said, I've got to be able to do something special for this team because it's a special team. High school sports are the extension of a community, and Richmond just love this team. You know why they love this team? Because these are great kids that played on this team. They're not a bunch of thugs. They're not a bunch of kids. They'd be kids I'd be honored to have as a son. I've gotten to know several of them. They're just, Sean, would you agree? They're just good kids. And that's what, to me, what high school sports is all about. And I'm sure your cheerleaders are the same way. You know, sometimes a team wins a state championship. Like I said, my high school, we never won a state championship in the major sports of Boone County. But, boy, we had some good teams. We went head-to-head with Trinity. I'm sure all you high school sports fans remember the Boone County-Trinity battles over the years. Am I right? Those were some unbelievable high school football battles. But we never won a state championship. So, you know, sometimes a team wins it for itself. The Indians team won this state title with class and for the whole Madison Central community. The school personnel, the citizens, and, of course, the students. Some of them are here. The alumni, the cheerleaders. You know, Karen does a great job with the cheerleading program. The band members. You know, my daughter was a marching band member, so I love the marching bands. That's why we have them on my TV show, because I love the marching bands. They work hard, too. How many times have we been at a game, we see the marching band out there practicing longer than the football team? Many, many times. So I love all high school. Everything related to high school sports. I've had cheerleaders on the show. Apologize for not having you on the show this year. We'll try to correct that next year, Karen, okay? We'll correct that next year. Love of community is what it's all about, and you know, and love of family. And that's why I have so much respect for Coach Feldhaus, because he dearly loves his team, his players, his family, you know, his children. Ashton's a great player. I've seen her. I've got to call her game at the state tournament when I worked with Julie over there for the Sweet 16, Miss Muntz. And, you know, high school sports to me, that's what it's, you know, that's where it starts for everybody. Everybody in this, not just, you know, even the parents here, the grandparents, a lot of us played high school sports. That's what molds us into the people we become. And that's why I'm here. My television show, The Scholastic Ball Report, is on WKYT. It highlights the accomplishments of male and female athletes throughout the state of Kentucky. I've never done this in 10 years, ladies, so just realize this is the first that we've ever done on the show. As the producer and the host of The Scholastic Ball Report, would the seniors on our team please come up with Coach Feldhaus? Because The Scholastic Ball Report TV show is naming Madison Central as our 2013 Team of the Year. We have a plaque, crown trophy, the Scholastic Ball Report Team of the Year, the Madison Central Boys Basketball 2013. And, of course, I know they've got a lot of plaques, but. Again, I want to thank you all for having me. Enjoy the rest of the banquet, and what a magical carpet ride. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Gary. Appreciate that very much. It has been a magical year. You know, I think back, and one of my memories on the basketball side of things was at the near the end of that Ballard game, as the Lexington police officers started making their way down to the Ballard end of the floor, trying to make sure those students didn't rush the floor. And I vividly remember one police officer said, "One bad pass, and we're all sprinting to the other end of the floor." You know that, don't you? So he was able to tell the future. Four times Madison Central has won the regional tournament, and my history that I did before that told me that this was the 10th time that a school from Madison County made it to the Sweet 16. After the regional tournament, I was congratulating Coach Feldhaus. I said, "Have you even gotten your hands on the regional championship trophy yet?" He said, "Correct me if I'm wrong, Sean, isn't there another trophy next week?" Coach Alan Feldhaus got his hands on it, Coach.
That's all right. Yeah, go ahead, Brad. Go ahead and show it. Yeah.
Expectations, without a doubt, were very high. I don't think we've ever had a team that's had eight seniors, let alone eight quality seniors the way this team had. So I think it was quite obvious we were expecting a lot just because of the type of schedule that we had. We knew coming in we were probably going to be preseason top five in the state. So we did not want to happen what happened the previous year when we got upset in the semifinals of the regional tournament. So we wanted to make daggone sure that our guys were prepared. And by being prepared, we wanted to find the best teams that we could play, not only in the state of Kentucky, teams from outside of the state. And, of course, we got to play against the Harrison Twins, and then went to West Virginia and played two really good out-of-state teams in that. So I think the preparation on our part as a coaching staff was good, because our guys were not shell-shocked once we got the state tournament playing against such quality competition, because we'd kind of been there, done that. Always say that the 11th region tournament is a mini state tournament in itself, because seems like most years, I guess this is the third time we've won it since I've been here at Madison Central, and most times you have to go through sometimes three top 20 teams to get there, and if not three, then definitely two.
Henry Clay is a very, very tough team. Catholic is too. And I know once we made it past those two that we had a good chance of winning state, you know, because in the running, Catholic could have done pretty good in state and Clay could have done pretty good in state.
We knew after we beat Henry Clay that it was going to be that we were one step closer to going to the state tournament. Honestly, we felt like Henry Clay, getting past Henry Clay was kind of the region championship, but we knew Catholic wasn't no slouch that we just can beat. So we knew that we had to come out with the same focus we did versus Henry Clay against Catholic, even though they weren't as talented as Henry Clay.
I had a pretty good feeling it was going to be a tight basketball game in that regional semifinal game. But still, I mean, we were down by four with, what, a minute and a half to go, I think, in that Henry Clay game. But I don't think our kids were ever in panic mode. I thought they stayed pretty cool and calm. And then, of course, Dominique gets a big three-point play, pulls us within one with less than a minute, and then Kenja makes the big steal and puts us ahead by one, and then we hit our free throws down the stretch like seniors are supposed to do.
And it just felt great to win the 11th region in how many years? 6 years? So, yeah.
MCS-TV's coverage of the 2013 Men's Basketball Awards Banquet will continue in a moment. Sponsored by Richmond Car and Truck Center, doing business the RCTC way, where quality and integrity are standard equipment, located on Atwood Drive. State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble in Richmond. Luxury Pet Service in Richmond. Premier Rehab, right here in Richmond. Renfro's Paint and Collision in Richmond and Berea. Davenport Custom Guitars, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, Richmond Tourism, First Gear, Row Signs, Berea Online, and WKYT.com. Another great sponsor for Madison County School Sports Television is Madison HVAC. Visit them at madisonhvacr.com.
2012-2013 Kentucky High School Athletic Association State Champion Madison Central Indians, Alan Feldhaus. Thank you. I get cold chills every time I watch that. Believe me, I've watched it several times. That's the introduction to our highlight tape that we had professionally done this year. I got an email after we won the regional tournament, and First String Media, a company out of Lexington, said that they would make a highlight tape, and they just charged like $125 for each one of your state tournament games. And so, of course, we had them to do all four of our games. It's the best $500 we've ever spent. Believe me, that's just the introduction. I'm just going to tease you a little bit. I'm going to show you the introduction, and then before I get through, I'm going to show you the ending of that tape. It's about an hour long. It's unbelievable. We do have them on sale back here in the back, and I think I've got like 50 copies. I can order as many as I need, and it just takes them a couple days to get those ready. But believe me, everybody needs to have one of those, and you'll see what I'm talking about, especially when we get to the ending. I couldn't stand it when we got it. I guess it was early last week when we got the highlight tape, and Karen and I watched it together, and just brings cold chills to me every single time I watch. And I said, we can't let anybody see this until the banquet. Well, I couldn't stand it. We had testing last week, and we were with some classes for 3 or 4 hours, so I had to show a little bit of it to my class, because I just had to share it with somebody because I was so excited about the highlight tape. So you get to see a little bit more of it here in a second. So now I know I've said this numerous times, I don't know how this season could have been any better than it was. I think I said at Dominique's press conference, if I was going to sit down before a season and write a script,
I don't think I would have changed a thing as far as the way it turned out. And I really don't think it sunk in what we accomplished. And I think that's what's so special about Kentucky high school basketball is that we're the only state that still has just one state championship team. Everybody else has gone to the class system, and that's what makes it even more special. So got a lot of things I want to talk about, and I'm usually not that long-winded. I think I'm really pretty quiet. But when it comes to basketball, when it comes to this team, I like to talk about this team. So I'll make it as fast as I can. So the first thing I want to do is bring all my guys up and give them their certificates of participation, and then I'll take care of the varsity awards, and then Coach Roberts will take care of the junior varsity awards, and Coach Fritz will take care of the freshman awards. Before I start, I would like to thank Gary Ball for coming. He has really been supportive, not only of high school basketball and high school sports in general, but he's really been supportive of Madison Central High School basketball. And I really appreciate everything, Gary, that you've done. And Gary brought Bridget DeVries, who is our former Kentucky High School Athletic Association commissioner, with him. I appreciate having you too, Bridget. I want to start with my managers. And guys, I'll call you up here, start with my managers, eighth graders, all the way up to my seniors. We'll form one big line, and Coach Roberts and Coach Fritz has your certificates. Our managers first, Justin Anderson. We'll go pretty quick here. Dante Cox, Devin Cox, and Gavin Daniel. The most photographed people on this entire basketball team are the two Cox twins. Every picture I saw with the trophy, they were right in the middle holding that trophy every single time. So that's our four managers. We had two eighth graders this year that played on our freshman team, and that's Jared Grant and Briar Rose. All right, our freshman class. Dante Altamirano, Dakota Begley, Grant Brockman, Andrew Haas, Dustin Johnson, Kyle Kelsey, Tariq Miller, Austin Puckett, Seth Richardson, Jared Selfridge, and Josh Wright. Coach Fritz will be talking about his freshman team a little bit later, so stay up here, guys. I want everybody to see all of my guys first. All right, our sophomores, Griffin Hotchkiss, Kirkland Humphrey, Sam Jones, Nick Cavanaugh, Jair Richardson, and Tariq Smith. It's our sophomores. I don't know, it must be something about the junior class. Karen said she didn't have any juniors. We've only got three ourselves. Our junior class, Cody Alexander, DeMarcus George, and Ross Ramsey. And then our seniors, Kenja Bosley, we doing all right there, Coach? Had it organized perfect for you, didn't it? Chris Connor, Dominique Hawkins. I'll be talking about these guys. So you can, I'll be talking about them more. I just want to recognize them all first. Zach Jarvis. Daniel Park. Hunter Stocker. Quan Taylor. And George Walker. That is our whole crew. They clean up pretty good, I will have to admit. So please give them a big round of applause. Fellas, y'all can take a seat. All right, I want to go ahead and talk a little bit about the varsity season. I first just want to read to you, because it's quite amazing just the accomplishments that this team had this year. Started off there at Christmas when we played in the King of Bluegrass tournament, which now that I look back, I think that was probably the most important 3 or 4 days of the season, other than the state tournament, because of the quality of competition that we played against in the King of the Bluegrass. We end up getting third place. We went 3-1. The team that won was out of Nashville, and they're the state championship team in their class in Tennessee. And Ballard was a runner-up team, and we finished third. But we went 3-1 in that tournament, and all three games that we won, we came from behind against Louisville St. X, against the host team Fairdale, and against Bullitt East. We won those three games. Of course, Ballard beat us in the, I guess it was the semifinal game of the King of the Bluegrass. I think it was like 88-86. But I think that tournament really prepared us for what was coming down the road. After that, after Christmas, we played in a tournament in West Virginia, played against two out-of-state teams, a team out of Columbus the first game, and then we beat the host team, South Charleston, who was undefeated at the time in the championship game. And I think we were down like 10 or 12 points at the half at that game. It just seemed to be a recurring theme of us getting down and somehow finding a way to come back. Of course, we're the 44th district champs, I think the 18th year in a row, 11th region champs, fourth time in school history, 87, 99, 2006, 2013. Of course, the 2013 Kentucky State champs for the first time in school history, and it's still amazing to me when you sit back and think how many, close to 300 schools in the state of Kentucky, and you got one winner, and we got that one trophy right there, and it's ours. And I don't even think our guys know yet. I got a call after the state tournament was over with, and some of you might be familiar with Max Preps, which is a service that covers high school sports throughout the United States. And I didn't know anything about this. I got a phone call, and there's over 20,000 high schools nationwide that participate in high school basketball. And we have been chosen by Max Preps as one of only 10 teams nationwide to be honored as what they call their Tour of Champions team. So there's actually going to be a representative from Max Preps coming to Madison Central. I can't remember the date, sometime here in the next couple of weeks to do a special presentation in front of the entire school. So over 20,000 schools in the United States, and we've been chosen as one of the 10. So I thought that was pretty special too. Now, yeah, that's fine. Now I think Mr. Thomas kind of hit the nail on the head. I think there's several reasons for our success and kind of what sets this team apart from other teams that we've had. I think one thing is we've got 8 seniors. And like I said there on the highlight, I don't think we've ever had a team that had 8 seniors, but especially 8 quality seniors like this. And these guys have been playing, and I know Karen was talking about how young they were. Well, I can remember when this group were freshmen, and Dominique had to start the entire year. George started a lot of the year. Quan started a lot of the year. Daniel started a game or two his freshman year. I mean, we had to throw these guys to the fire as freshmen, because when they were freshmen, we didn't have a single senior on the team. So we had to make these guys grow up in a hurry, and they definitely did, and I think it paid off in the long run. I think the second reason for our success is that we were so prepared. Our schedule was incredible. I think I figured out 18 out of the 37 games that we played were played against teams who at one time or another ranked in the top 10 in the state of Kentucky. So 18 out of those 37 games against top 10 competition, that doesn't include the three out-of-state teams that we played, who definitely would be good enough to be in the top 10 in the state of Kentucky. So I think that's the main reason why our guys were not in shock once we got to the state tournament, because if you'll look, those last three games, not just Ballard, if you look at Hoptown, if you look at Covington Holmes, I think those were the three most athletic, talented teams in the state tournament, and we had to go through all three of them, and we had to come from behind against all three of them. So I think a lot of it had to do with that preparation leading up to the state tournament, that our guys were not in shock, and I think that's why they stayed so calm and cool under pressure. I think another biggie, another reason for our success, is that everyone bought in to the same goal. And I've been doing this for a long time. This is my 27th year, and I don't care what sport you're talking about. I don't care if you're talking about basketball, baseball, football, cheerleading. Hey, especially cheerleading. If everyone's not on the same page, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. All it takes is one bad apple to spoil the whole bunch. That's all it takes. And I can proudly say that we didn't have that one bad apple this year. When I talk about everyone has to be on the same page, I'm not just talking about the players. I'm not just talking about the coaches. I'm talking about the parents. Everybody has to be on the same page. So I can proudly say that I think our parents were on the same page with everybody else, because I think we all could see that there was something special at the end if we would stay on the same page. And look what happened. Look what can happen when everybody has the same goal in mind. So at this time, I'd like to say a special thanks to my parents. You all made it a special season too, and I want you all to make sure that you feel that you were part of this success, because you definitely were. Now, for me as a coach, I think the number one thing, and Mr. Thomas, he said it, we've had a lot of good teams since I've been here. Last year's team, 131 basketball games, 31-2, but got upset in the semifinals of the regional tournament. I think that the biggest difference between this year's team and last year's team was that every single person on this team understood their role. Dominique, Kenja, Quan, their role really didn't change that much from last year to this year. I mean, those were our big three as far as scoring was concerned. But the biggest difference in this year's team were those other guys. Were Daniel, Hunter, George. And what I'm talking about, they understood their role. They understood, and we knew as a team when that game was on the line, and we had a lot of games where, hey, 3 minutes to go, it's anybody's ball game. They knew whose hand we wanted that ball on. They knew who we wanted to take those crucial shots. I think the best example is that last play. George makes that steal. How long did it take George to find Dominique? About 0.25 seconds. He knew exactly what to do with it. And that's what made this team special. That's the difference between having a good team, we're very good last year, and having a great team, which we have this year, is having guys that understand their roles, have very defined roles. And these guys did that. And look what can happen when everybody, like I said earlier, is on the same page and understands that. So I think that was the the main reasons why we were so successful. Now, I want to get to our awards. I'll be able to talk about some of these guys individually. Hey, guys, I'm not going to read off all of our GPAs the way Karen did with the cheerleaders because we can't, I mean, it's not even close. We can't compare with them. So I'm not even going to, we don't have those 4.0s or 4.2s, but I'm going to give an academic award for my sophomore, juniors, and seniors, the person who has the highest GPA, and then Coach Fritz will give one for our freshmen. So Coach Fritz and I, we'd forgot about it. We knew we always order an academic trophy, and we forgot to go to the counselors to ask, so we had to get on Coach Fritz's Infinite Campus yesterday. The highest GPA for a sophomore, junior, or senior receiving our academic award is Mr. Daniel Park. Daniel, come over here. All right, my next three, and I'll be talking about Daniel a little bit later. Our next three awards is really the same award. I call this something special this year. I called it my Super Sub Award. These are three guys who at certain times throughout the course of the season were called upon to step up in crucial situations. And guys, y'all can kind of, I'll kind of read who it's about, and y'all can tell who it is when I get finished. This guy, George Walker, got thrown out the first time we played Bullet East because I guess he thought he'd pick on the biggest guy in the state of Kentucky, Derek Willis, and he kind of picked on him, and George got thrown out of the game. So it just so happened the game that he got thrown out of was right before we were going to play in the King of the Bluegrass. So when you get thrown out of a game, you got to sit out two games. So here we are, going up to play in the King of the Bluegrass against Louisville teams, and you don't go to Louisville and beat Louisville teams. We all know that, and we're going to have to play without our first sub off the bench. Well, if you've ever been to the King of the Bluegrass in Fairdale High School's gymnasium, it's unique. You'll have about 15 or 20 guys sitting behind your bench with their billfolds out, and they're betting on every play down the floor. I'm serious. They're betting on who's going to win. There was one heckler. I don't pay any attention to the people in the stands, but I guess he was giving me heck the entire game. I know they had to escort him out before Karen whipped him, but he was in that same area where these guys were making these bets. Well, these guys fell in love with this player. He hit some big-time shots in some crucial situations. He had 8 points against St. X when we came from behind late in the fourth quarter. Hit some big shots in overtime against Fairdale. I remember he hit a big three right in front of our bench and put us ahead for the first time. George goes out in Charleston, South Carolina. They had us down. They were working on us at the half, and we fighting our way back in at the second half, and I think we finally took the lead by two or three with like 2 or 3 minutes to go, and George's shoulder comes out of place. He gets fouled. His shoulder came out of place, and we got to pick somebody off that bench to come in to hit two crucial free throws. He stepped to the free throw line, knocked down both of them, cool and calm. Some of those guys that were making bets, they were waiting for him in the locker room to congratulate him up there at the King of the Bluegrass. Guys, who am I talking about, our first super sub? Cody Alexander. Cody, hate to tell you, won't be a sub next year. Expecting big things from you. All right, that's our first super sub. Next one. Two quality post players coming off the bench for us this year, and they really showed up in crucial times throughout the course of the year. First one I want to honor was our last loss. I remember this game clearly. Our last loss of the season was at Russell County. Unfortunately, coached by my brother. So I've got the bragging rights with the rest of Kentucky, but I don't have the bragging rights with him because they did beat us. But I think that night we were playing against eight people rather than five, but that's neither here nor there. Quan, I think, got to play a grand total of about 4 minutes for the entire game, and I think he might have made one foul, but he got five called on him. But this player stepped up. He had 15 points that game. I think it was our very next game against South Laurel. He had 13 points. And he ended up the season being our fifth leading scorer on the team. And I've told him numerous times, and he's gonna get out of it because we're going to stay on him. If he would be more consistent with his work ethic, he could be a special basketball player because he's got a lot of God-given ability. He's strong, and he plays with a lot of confidence. But if we can just get him to come in that gym and work hard every single day, he could really make some waves these next 2 years. Guys, who am I talking about? Sam Jones. That's exactly right. All right, our last super sub really stepped up in tournament time. Played a lot of quality minutes in the state tournament, the regional tournament. Did a great job for us defensively. I remember in that Henry Clay game in the semifinals of the regional tournament, they thought they had a mismatch and they were going to turn Grundy loose because this player was guarding him. He couldn't get a shot off. He couldn't get a good shot off. And played some tremendous minutes in the state tournament. Even started one of those games when Quan was out buying his socks. But really stepped up big in those games. And I just liked his confidence when he was in there. He didn't look out of place. And expecting big things from him next year, and that's DeMarcus George. All right, next award, six-man award. I think that's pretty obvious who this is going to go to. Probably one of the most versatile players that I've ever had the opportunity to coach. I think he could play any position on the floor, offensively or defensively. He loves to guard, doesn't care about scoring, even though he did have a couple games where I think over at Collins he had 19 points against Madison Southern. He had four threes. He can score. But he realized we had other people that can score too, and that's what made him so special. Had a little nasty streak in him, which that was good too. If you don't think so, ask Derek Willis. He'll tell you about his nasty streak. To me, he's just the ultimate team player, and I think he will go down in history as making the biggest steal ever in Madison Central history, and that's Mr. George Walker. Stumpy. All right, our next award, I'm calling this the Ultimate Teammate Award because this player really didn't lead us in any particular category, but he was just so solid in all aspects of the game. And he was one of those players I'm talking about that really understood his role and what we needed for him to do, for this basketball team to be successful, was to knock down open shots when he had them, because he was going to get some open shots, was to rebound for us, and to be very solid defensively. And he did all of those things, and did all of those things with class, and he's a winner. He has a tremendous winning attitude, and it was people like him, I'm telling you, that set us apart from last year's team because his willingness to accept his role on this team. So our Ultimate Teammate Award goes to Hunter Stocker. All right, my next award. And this really kind of surprised me when I checked the stats at the end of the year. It really kind of surprised me because I didn't know he led us in these two categories. This player led the team in three-point field goal percentage, and he also had the most assists of any player on the team. And our assists were close. There were three players within 10 assists of one another. This person ended up having the most assists, and I thought he had a tremendous year. Kind of quiet. Kind of stayed out of the limelight, but he, another one of those players that really understood what his role was. Very solid defender. He liked the challenge of guarding a good player. And I like that as a coach when somebody wants to take that good player. I think probably why he's so successful that he had a little nasty streak in him too, which never hurts defensively. He would knock down the open shots, and he would get some open shots because Dominique and Kenja were getting so much attention defensively. Ended up shooting 37% from the three-point line, which was best on the team. He knew how to find our scores in crunch time, therefore ending up leading our team in assist with, I can't remember exactly, almost three assists per game, 110 assists. I think he was a difference maker for us this year. I know it's those other three that probably get a lot of the attention, a lot of the awards, but I'm telling you, it's those second three guys that I think really deserve a lot of credit. He made the all-regional tournament team. At the state tournament, he received the Bob Roberts Insurance Scholarship and also the Uncommon Excellence Award, Mr. Daniel Park. All right, our next award goes to the person who led the team in field goal percentage. And he was our rebounding award winner. And my favorite, and I'll go ahead and make a plug, those pictures back there in the back have Coach Wade Upchurch, who has a picture display back here in the back, and I've known Coach Upchurch for a long time. He brought those pictures to our office there 2 or 3 weeks after the state tournament. And, hey, Coach, if you'll hold up that one picture of Quan and myself down at the bottom, I think that's my favorite picture of all of them, and that's with Quan giving me a big hug there. And the caption, I don't know if he knew the situation or what, but if you look at that caption, it says, "Sometimes we wonder why we coach." With Quan, in the 4 years that I have Quan, I've asked myself that question. Sometimes I wonder, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? But the bottom part of that caption, it's moments like that which makes me realize why I'm doing what I'm doing. And you'll see on the highlight tape, you get to actually see that. But the most important thing, you don't get to see it, you get to hear Quan. Because when he's hugging, well, I was crying too. I'll be the first to admit I was crying too. But he was crying a lot louder than I was. I promise you that. You'll be able to hear that here in a second. So I thought that was very appropriate that Coach Upchurch put that caption on that picture. That's my favorite. I think I did earn my money coaching this young man, but I think he did make me grow as a coach. I think he made me become a little bit more understanding and a little bit more patient as a coach. I think I helped him, but I think he also helped me. So I just loved his very unselfish, burning desire to win. I know I've used the adjective with him. He's a freak of nature athletically. Some of the things he can do are just so impressive. Had one of the, and you'll see it on the highlight tape here in a second, that post move that he makes in the fourth quarter of that Ballard game, that's one of the prettiest post moves I've ever seen in my life. One, two, three fakes, sticks it in with his left hand. You'll see that. I can remember when Gary and Brian were calling that on TV, they were both talking, that's an old school move. That's the type of move you use against your dad out in the backyard. I still remember that. Made the all-region team, made the all-regional tournament team, made the all-state tournament team. He was honorable mention All-State in the Lexington Herald and the Courier-Journal. He shot 52% from the field, which led the team, and he averaged 8 rebounds per game. Mr. Quan Taylor. Oh, and block shots, too. He led in all that stuff. All right, next award goes to the player who had the most three-point field goals, led the team in free throw percentage, and had the most steals. Finished his career with 1,338 points. In my opinion, one of the best guards in the state, hands down. Hit 87 threes to lead the team. Shot 79.3% from the free throw line to lead the team. Had 72 steals to lead the team. Made the all-region team, all-regional tournament team, made the all-state tournament team, made second-team all-state in the Lexington Herald and the Courier-Journal, also made the Kentucky All-Star team that will be competing against Indiana this summer. And last but not least, of course, he will be known, be go down in history for hitting the biggest shot ever in Madison Central history. And, of course, that is Kenja Bosley. And there's just – stay there for a second, Kenja. There's just something – there's something special about guys who like to take that last-second shot. And he had a lot of them throughout the course of the year. I can remember we're down by three against Louisville St. X, first game of the King of the Bluegrass. He'd had a temperature of 102 the last two or three days. Hits, what, 32, 35-footer to send it into overtime. Scored like 17 points in the last 3 minutes of the fourth quarter in the overtime. He likes those last-second shots. Wayne County game, hits a 60-footer at the end of the first half. And I could tell. I could tell when he went up, when the ball was deflected, Dominique gets fouled, and it goes right to Kenja. I mean, he didn't hesitate. I mean, I could tell he knew he was going to hit that shot. I knew he was going to hit that shot. I mean, I thought for sure it was going to go in as soon as he left his hands. So something really special about guys who are willing to take that shot. Really impressed with what Kenja's done as far as talking to the media. I think he was very articulate when speaking to the media, and you'll see on the highlight tape, he does a tremendous job on the highlight tape when they talk to him. Very proud of this young man. I'm sure he's here in the next week or two. He's going to be making an announcement where he plans on playing his college basketball. So, Mr. Kenja Bosley. Next player, leading scorer, most two-point field goals, defensive award. I don't know what else I can say about this young man that hadn't already been said. Finished his career with 2,453 points. All-time leading scorer in Madison Central history. Averaged 20.2 points per game. I think really, and I looked at it, Dominique had like 50-something more points than Kenja. They were both very, very close for being the leading scorer. Had the most two-point field goals with 259. Also receives the defensive award. And here's the thing I've noticed as a coach. We're kind of old school in the way we do things. We play against all these good players throughout the course of the year. And we go back and we watch the film after the game. And to me, I don't know, maybe it's the way I was brought up and playing for my dad. He always had his best players. His best players offensively were his best players defensively. And he would challenge his best players offensively to guard the best players on the other team. We'd go play all these other teams throughout the course of the year. We played the Harrison Twins. They didn't want any part of Dominique. They didn't guard him the entire game. They had other people guarding him. I'm thinking about the Snyder kid from Ballard. He didn't try to check Dominique. Yet every game that we played, we would have Dominique on the best perimeter player on the other team. And I think that's what even makes it more special. And what he did offensively is that we required so much out of him defensively, which we do all of our kids. So to me, that's special. And sometimes coaching-wise, you look at that, and I've always done that. I mean, my better players are my better defenders too. And we make them better defenders because that's what we believe in. And he liked the challenge. That's what I liked about him. He liked the challenge, as did Kenja. And Daniel was a great defender, and I think that's why we're so successful. George was a terrific defender. Well, they're all great defenders. That's why we're successful. All right, here's the list. Let's just say this. Every big individual award in the state of Kentucky, he got every single one of them. They got every single one of them. 11th region, player of the year. MVP, 11th region tournament. MVP, state tournament. First team All-State and player of the year in the Lexington Herald Leader, the Louisville Courier Journal, and Associated Press. Named the 2013 Gatorade Kentucky Player of the Year. Was named Madison Central's first Kentucky's Mr. Basketball. And in doing so, he will get to wear that number one jersey this summer in the Kentucky-Indiana All-Star Game that I have the privilege and honor of being his coach, he and Kenja. And, of course, he signed a scholarship to play basketball at the University of Kentucky. So, what else can you say? And last week, I got something in the mail. Congratulations on being selected as a member of the 2012-2013 Kentucky High School Coaches Association's Outstanding Senior in Your Sport. So, every single individual award you could get, he got every single one of them, Dominique Hawkins. All right, turn around there, Dominique. Don't leave yet. Get to embarrass you for a second. You know the most amazing thing to me? Is to see how far Dominique's come along talking to people. I'll never forget. Of course, we had to call him as a freshman. He was our leading scorer as a freshman. Gary, when we went over to see you at the Scholastic Ball Report, I think it was Dominique's freshman year, I can't remember what question it was that you asked him. And he starts telling you about these new plays that we had put in called Red and Green. I'll never forget that. You remember that, Dominique? But that was his freshman year. A lot of you got to see, or some of you actually witnessed his press conference when he committed to the University of Kentucky. I was so impressed with how he handled himself, how he carried himself. And I think people in the state tournament, I think they fell in love, not with what type of player he was, that was obvious, but just what type of person he is. And I think Big Blue Nation, They're going to fall in love with him too. Not because of his playing abilities, but just what type of kid he is. Always got that contagious smile on his face. And as a coach, I've just seen him grow up, and I'm just really proud of the way you've handled yourself, Dominique. So I want to wish you a lot of luck. Dominique Hawkins. All right, and before I wrap up, Brad, if you'll show that, the ending. This is the ending of our highlight tape, and this is something very special.
The main thing, I mean, hey, this is a once-in-a-lifetime thing, getting to play in the finals of the Sweet 16. I said enjoy every single moment of it. Enjoy the video. Enjoy when they're doing announcing all of our administrators. And enjoy it. Soak it up. So I thought once they cleared all that out of the way and we still had 3 minutes to warm up, then we'd know when it was time to, you know, go to work.
I think as coaches, and you might call it crazy, but thinking about it, I think we were calm because we've been in a lot of tight games over the years, and you know, you got a lot of experienced coaches here on this staff. And looking back, watching the game film, I'm thinking we were pretty calm.
Hey! 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 Shoot! Hey! Thank you.
stay in practice, I was thinking about this. But you only need to care to see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause all of my life, training day and night, I'm preparing to fight for everyone in the league. While I was feeling the same, yeah, they screaming our name. While we spraying champagne, nothing nobody can say. Cause today is the day.
Into the camera, tell my mama I love her, girl.
Today is the day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever. When you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Oh, all my blood, sweat, and mine was all for this time.
Today is the day. Is the day that I...
with a little bit of time left, and I was just thinking, we still have a chance. You know, we've been like this every game since the semifinals of the regional tournament. I was like, we can do this. And then we got, you know, we cut it to two, and then they call a timeout, and I'm just sitting there thinking, we got to get a steal. We just got to. I was like, we got to get a steal, or we're going to lose this game.
Well, it's kind of like I tell people, it's, you know, I felt like it was just meant to be for us, and you know, it felt like that, you know, starting to get really against Henry Clay in the region semifinals. You know, you just feel like something good is gonna happen, you just don't know when. And you know, at that point in the game, we were just like, I knew something, I was just waiting for something to happen, but I didn't know, you know, it hadn't happened yet. So you know, you're preparing you know, for the worst, but like you're just hoping for that moment to come, you know, for your team to get back on top.
And I think that was just one of our stories, just not giving up, because I mean, 15 seconds is a long time in the game of basketball.
We were going to foul anybody other than Snyder. We just didn't want Snyder to catch the basketball, so we did a really good job of putting two people on him and making them look somewhere else.
All he said was double Quentin. Quentin is their best free throw shooter. He's their best player. So obviously that's going to try to get him the ball. So all our strategy was is let somebody else catch the ball and shoot the free throws.
At the end of the game, it was pretty exciting with 15 seconds left.
Coach was just like, everybody just stay calm, because we've been in plenty of situations like this, going back to the King of the Bluegrass and all those other tournaments we've been in. We've been down and came back in one game. So I think that when pressure's on us, we handle it well.
I wasn't shocked until the timeout was called, because I'm just like, what happened? The first thing I thought when I made the shot is get back on defense, because I didn't even know how much time was left. But when I saw the shot go in, saw that the buzzer didn't go off, so obviously there was still time left on the clock. So first thing I was doing is trying to run on defense, and I heard the whistle blow for a timeout, and all I thought was, oh my gosh, we just won the state championship. So I was just... It was surreal. It was crazy. I was lost for words then, but I mean, I can explain it better now.
Right, you know, we knew we had to be poised to let them see that it's not over. A lot can happen in 2.2 seconds. You've been around a lot of basketball. You know, anything can happen. And then we made an adjustment to put DeMarcus on the basketball to try to stop them from seeing down the floor. And we wanted them to catch it on our side of half court, so they had a long shot to take. We just told him to be calm. Defense is what carries us, and let's play defense for 2.2 seconds to get the job done.
Yeah, I was at the Duke-UK game in Philadelphia a long time ago when my brother's playing. I know exactly what can happen in 2 seconds, so I knew we still had some work to do. And I think everybody, of course, I really didn't notice that at the time when I go back and I watch the game on TV, and that's the best part, is just watching the reaction from everybody else, not only my players, just the people in the crowd, the Ballard players. And I think everybody was in shock. Our guys, I think, and then Kenja's expression after, I think he was, not that he made the shot, I don't think it's surprising that he made the shot. I think everybody was in shock because they look up there and we're ahead. I mean, we hadn't been ahead that much in that game, and we're ahead and there's only 2 seconds left to go. And I think the Ballard kids were in shock, and they're saying to them, we're behind. We're getting ready to lose if we don't hit a miraculous shot. So I knew we still had some work to do. I thought they would probably throw it long and try to get off a shot on their end of the floor. So I was really happy when Snyder caught it where he did, and he had to hit a 50, 60 footer to win the game. And I could tell as soon as it left his hand, it was going to be off to the right. So I knew it was all over then.
Thank you. such good team chemistry, and we keep fighting to the end.
Talk about what you saw when the shot went in.
Oh, when Bond's shot went in, I thought it was a dream.
Coaching point of view, as a high school coach in this state, I mean, it doesn't get any better. It doesn't get any better. It's the ultimate. It's the ultimate. And it's like I've told some people in the community, these guys, they took the coaches for a heck of a ride. They let us get on the bus and get on the ride and go along with them. I mean, I think of all the people that have played here and good teams that we've had that didn't get to the state tournament, and I think our senior class fulfilled a dream, and I know I've had a lot of people in the community tell me how proud they are, people that played here, how proud they are of this basketball team and the basketball program and the school. I mean, it's just a great thing for our community.
You never really know what it's like until you get there. I had a roommate in college who won it in 1998, and you know, still talking to him, he can't explain what it's like. But for me, to see, I'm the freshman coach, I get to see the kids grow every single day. And to think back when they were freshmen to where they are now, they've turned from kids to young men. And for me to see that and see them get to go out on top, it really makes me feel like we had a special group of young men.
Just to see how proud that we made our families and the schools and the teachers, just how proud they were of all of us, was just awesome.
Well, the first thing was I want to get to all my teammates. You know, that's something that we've all worked for since, you know, earlier than even freshman year. We all played AAU ball together. You know, that's just something I just wanted to celebrate with my teammates and that. Just wanted to go around, give everybody hugs, just celebrate.
Just running out there, and then after all the individual awards are given out, and then you just hear, and your state champions are Madison Central Indians, just to walk over there and take that trophy knowing that this is my last game and this is the way, and it's an awesome feeling. And I feel like when I looked up in those stands and all those people just start cheering and going off and going crazy, I just realized they brought us back together.
The feeling was incredible. Like, it's something that you think will never happen. To win a game like that, you just think there's no way impossible that you probably win a game like that. But in my head, I was thinking we was going to win this game somehow. And after winning it, the feeling was a feeling that I never had before. I couldn't even describe the feeling. It was just amazing, and I couldn't believe that it happened. And I was just so excited at the end once the buzzer went off and we was winning.
I'm so happy for Coach Fieldhouse, who by far is my favorite coach I've ever played for, from middle school, any rank, AAU, just my favorite coach I've ever played for. He's like a second father to me. He does anything for anybody. He's a great person. And I think that's the main reason why I'm so happy we won it for him, because he's an even better person than he is a coach.
I don't know how many calls I've got from people I don't even know who have congratulated me and telling me how much it means. And just to do it for the city of Richmond and go out there and play hard for the city of Richmond and the school, it's just an awesome feeling to know that we made them proud.
I'm so happy. Like, he deserved it more than all of us, because he was wanting this since he's been here, you know. And he's all about winning, defense. He's a great coach. And I just think he needed that.
It's been a long time coming. It's been a long time coming. I thought back of how I felt when we lost when I played in 1981, and Dad was my coach, and it kind of erased some of that sting. And I know Coach Fritz and Coach Roberts, our whole coaching staff, kind of got in a little huddle there and we're all hugging each other. And I think Coach Fritz, because I don't know what I was thinking, Coach Fritz said, Coach, all you said was, we just won the state championship. We just won the state championship. And then I said, come on, we got to go shake hands. So I don't know. It's special. It's very special. And especially when you grow up in a family like I've grown up in, where Kentucky high school basketball is, I mean, that's what we are. That's what we've grown up in our entire lives. And with Dad being coach, and of course, both my brothers playing and one of them coaching, it's you can't get any better. And I mean, that's the pinnacle in my book. But yeah, I think it's been great. Of course, it's been great for the entire community. We were shocked when we got back. Of course, they had the fire engines waiting for us, but when we started pulling down Main Street just to see how many people were out there, that was amazing. And we thought there'd be a good crowd, but I mean, there was a lot more people there than I thought would be there. And of course, most of them just walked it on in from downtown straight to the gym here when we did our pep rally. And everybody, even people from the southern end of the county, even people that support Madison Southern and Berea and Model, I think it brought the whole county together. And they've been very good to us, very good, even since it's over with, they've been very good to us. So something like this, it can bring, you know, an entire community together. And I don't know, maybe they're not old enough to realize that, to realize what they've actually accomplished, but it will hit them. It might be 10 years down the road, but I promise you it will hit them.
Cause inside you knew one shining moment you reach for the sky. One shining moment you knew. One shining moment you willing to try. One shining moment you knew. One shining moment.
That is a highlight tape. That's probably about half of it. There's a segment which talks about the 11th region tournament and then our other three games in the state tournament. It's about an hour long, and I'd love for all of you to purchase one of those. I think that's something that I know I'll watch at least once a month the rest of my life. I know that it gives me cold chills every time that I watch it. And to wrap up for me, it's just nice to know that, I mean, I think we're kind of old school in the way we do things, in that we stress hard work, we stress toughness, and we stress defense. It's just nice to know that you can still be successful doing those things. And it just takes a special group of kids that believe in those three aspects, which we definitely had. And it was just amazing the way it all turned out, the way we came from behind. But, Quan, you could tell them our battle cry for the entire year when we got behind, coach called that timeout. What would I tell them that we'd have to do when we get behind? Answer the call. And these guys, they definitely answered the call. I'm just really proud of them. So, thanks a lot.
Coach Roberts, did you have a few awards you were going to do as well? All right, go ahead. Let's get Chip. I was a little disappointed. I was thrown off. I was sad in your interview there that you'd already taken the earring out. So,
I think I'm just going to become a movie star. I don't even like watching myself on film, I'll tell you that right now. Yeah, I know everybody does, but I don't like it. Well, I tell you, as a guy who sat on the bench at Madison Central for 30 years and proudly graduated there several years ago, what a ride this has been. You know, for grown men to put their hands or their fate in the hands of teenage kids to help them win a state championship, I mean, I tell you, that's awesome. And we've had some, as Alan said, we've had some good players, good teams there. We always knew we had a good basketball program at Madison Central, but this year, hey, we got a state championship program, and nobody can ever take that away from us. Coach Feldhaus mentioned some of the awards that those varsity kids got, and I'm going to take care of the JV here in just a moment. And I don't know, Brandon, did you have anything you were going to say about the things that Allen had done this year? Did you have anything you were going to say about those? Well, you don't care if I say a couple of things myself, do you? Of course, you know, it's hard for somebody to get up here and toot their own horn, and I don't think Allen would ever do that. But this year, he got his 500th win as a high school basketball coach. He was the Harold Weider Coach of the Year, Kerr Journal Coach of the Year, and of course going to coach Kentucky Indian All-Stars this summer. So certainly that's something that I know myself and Coach Fritz are a little bit a part of it, but I mean, we're happy for Allen for that. Now, as I mentioned something about the JV team, I'd like for all the kids that play JV to just come up here and stand right in front of the podium, if you don't mind. All you guys that play JV, come on up here, and I'm going to say something about you. You could tell how good we were this year. We knocked over a chair. The chair just took a charge. I want to mention everybody's name that played JV, and as I do, just why don't you just take one step forward a little bit, you know, so everybody can recognize you, although I'm sure everybody already knows who you are. Seth Richardson, Griffin Hotchkiss, Kirkland Humphrey, Sam Jones, Nick Cavanaugh, Jair Richardson, Tariq Smith, Cody Alexander, DeMarcus George, Ross Ramsey. Their record this year was 14-3. They lost to Henry Clay and Lafayette by 2 points apiece, and Trinity by 9. Very proud of this year's team. You know, kept telling them all along, and basically, with a few additions, this is next year's basketball team at Madison Central. And I think, obviously, with what we're losing, we told these kids this year, hey, it's wide open next year as far as playing time. And we kept saying, hey, you're next year's team. You are next year's team. And I think they realized that. And for most of the nights, I think, they answered the call. And, you know, I mean, we can feel sorry for ourselves because we're losing some great players off this year's basketball team, some great players. But I think we'll do what we do best. We'll coach these guys, and you know, we'll play the schedule, and we will surprise some people next year and be pretty competitive. Here are the award winners, and as I call your name, if you'll go over and see Coach Fritz, he will give you your award. Leading scorer this year, Sam Jones. Leading rebounder, DeMarcus George. Two-point field goal percentage leader, Sam Jones.
It's on there, Brent. It's on the one he's got on.
3-point field goal percentage leader, Cody Alexander. award, Ross Ramsey. You know, Alan spoke on these guys a little earlier. I would like to say this for my three juniors that played this year and going to be, of course, seniors next year. I think for the most part, DeMarcus, Cody, and Ross provided good leadership on the JV team this year, and we're looking for them to do the same thing next year. So, you know, you can say, hey, you're feeling sorry for us because we're losing some great players off this year's varsity basketball team. But like I said, we'll do what we do best. We'll coach them up and play the schedule and be as competitive as we can be. Thank you.
All right, it's time to welcome everybody's favorite assistant coach other than Coach Roberts, right? Brandon Fritz.
They never help the vertically challenged people with this mic. Real quick, I want to thank these seniors – I can remember back. Elsa, she had to go somewhere, my daughter, but my wife, oh, there she is. Brooke was pregnant. Quan, she had the house as clean as it's ever been. We have two kids now, so I don't know if it'll ever get back that way. But she had the house as clean as it's ever been. She's having a baby shower. As always, we're going to play summer basketball. And Quan comes to me and says, Coach, Mom's going out of town. I'm not going to be able to go. And I said, well, that's not an option. You have to go play the summer game. So little did I know, Quan's at my house that night, sleeping on a blow-up mattress. I think by morning I had 11 kids there. To get to the bus at Central, I had to call Coach. I couldn't get them in the truck. But that's kind of how the seniors started with me. Everybody was together, and that's how we finished. But for you, you've done some special things this year, you seniors. I challenge you. You've made one dream come true that all of you had. I challenge you to chase your other dreams. Don't let this be your last. Chase your other dreams. Don't let anybody stand in your way. And go achieve bigger dreams because they're out there for each and every one of you. Like to thank my wife. I leave in the morning, she's asleep. I get home at night, and she's got the girls asleep, and she's asleep most of the time as well, exhausted. And that goes for 7 months a year, if not more. So I couldn't have done any better as far as a wife. And I have now two beautiful girls that Elsa has more energy than anybody. So I guess I'm getting paid back for my childhood. Thank my father-in-law, caretakers, Coach Rob calls him. He's my critic, and for you parents, he's always cheering for the guy that didn't get to play. And he's in my ear saying, you should have put him in, you should have put him in. So he's their biggest fan as well, and he always keeps me balanced when I'm out there because I get caught up in some things. Next, people I want to thank Dean Reed, Dino. Dino's been around for a long time, seen a lot of basketball games. It's people like him that this championship really meant a lot to. Dino and Jimmy Hackworth and John Hancock. And I can always look up when we have those triple headers. And we don't have many fans at our freshman games, but those three guys are there. And I appreciate that. It means a lot to have those guys there. Next, I want to thank Dante and Devin Cox, the managers. Not many know this. We have our 6 a.m. practices, and I don't think Dante missed one practice. And when I asked Devin, he never refused. He was always there to come to practice. So I'd pick him up about 5:30 every morning for practice, and he'd run that clock for us, which meant a lot for us in that practice. So I really appreciate that. Next, I want to thank the parents of my freshmen. Breyer's dad, he asked me, we had tryouts yesterday, and he said, why are you doing this early stuff again? I said, well, you get to do those 6 a.m. one more year, my friend. So thank you for getting those kids there. I can't remember one kid that was late this year. That means a lot to me as a coach. And I think most mornings we started practice at 5:55 a.m., and that gave us 5 extra minutes, and that means a lot when you're working with freshmen. So thank you, parents, for being diligent and getting your kids there. The players, I tell everybody I had 15 of the best kids I've ever had. I've ever had the opportunity to coach. I remember Coach come in after our last game, and he thanked them. Great attitudes, great work ethic. I just can't say enough. I enjoyed going to practice. I enjoyed when that alarm went off at 5 a.m., knowing I got to go to practice, and there's going to be 15 guys there that's going to give it everything they got. And we lacked in some areas this year, but we made up for it with our hard work and our effort every single day. I think we had 30 practices that were 6 a.m. practices, and I can't remember one bad practice. We got better every single day in practice, and that's good. About these players, they loved each other, and
we saw what loving each other can do with the varsity. This group, man, they cared for one another. Guys wasn't getting in the game as much, and I looked up, and they're the biggest cheerleaders in the gym. And as a coach, knowing that we're all together, we're on the same page, it makes the world of difference. And there was times I wanted to play all 15 guys. But, again, we're going to try to win games. But nobody complained. They just worked hard and did their business, and I really, really appreciated that. This team this year, we went 11-6. And I told them all year, I said, guys, I don't have mediocre kids. I had great kids, and I said, we're not going to have a mediocre record. And saying mediocre was 500. Those guys bought into that. They believed they were good. They worked hard. Nobody blew them out of the gym this year, and they were in every basketball game, and they won their last five basketball games because they're not mediocre people. They're great people, and that made a huge difference. Like I said, great attitudes, and at the end of the day, I could say every one of these kids were just high-character individuals, and that's what we talked about a lot. Every practice, at the end of practice, I had a quote for them, some of them silly. Some of them meant something about building character, building the team, building the individual. And those guys, they would just look at me, they would listen, and they would try to take every bit of that in. So thank you guys for everything that you did this year. Coach called them up, so I'm not going to make them all come up again. But I'll get to the awards. This young man, he was an eighth grader this year. He ended up being our leading rebounder. At the beginning of the year, I knew he had the talent. I knew he had the ability. I just couldn't get it out of him. But he kept working. He gained confidence throughout the year. And I think his last three or four basketball games, he had double digits rebounding. So he became our leading rebounder, and that's Briar Rose. A little quicker, buddy. Come on up. I'll go ahead and go with the next award since Briar's taking his time. Most three-point field goals. I looked at, we played 17 basketball games, and we hit 39 threes. We weren't great shooters, but like I said, they worked their butts off. They kept shooting that basketball. And really, to be honest, we have some guys that can shoot the basketball. They just needed to believe they can shoot the basketball. And towards the end, I know Kyle, he started really shooting the basketball well, and Tariq started shooting the basketball well. Those are both guys that can really shoot the basketball well. But Tariq edged him out this year. He struggled early in the season, but as the season went on, he got more confident, started believing. So our leading three-point field goal, Tariq Miller. Our defensive award, I've had the opportunity to coach this young man for two seasons. And I don't guess you're supposed to have favorite players as a coach, but if somebody asked me, I would say he's one of my favorites. His work ethic's unbelievable. If you ask him to run through the wall, he's going through the wall. He's strong. He's quick. He's very talented, very smart. Had the game-winning hit for the baseball team the other night, the varsity baseball team. Our best defender this year was Seth Richardson. I'll go on. Our 110% award, and really I had to think about this one a long, long time. Because like I said, I had 15 guys, and every one of them laid it on the line every single day. And worked extremely hard. But this guy, he just kind of stands out just a little bit more than everybody. And he worked hard, weight room, getting extra shots up, every practice. He was on the floor. He was doing whatever you ask him to do. If he wasn't in the game, he was cheering his teams on. Just a great, great attitude. He's the ultimate team player. I can remember Coach Roof, they were having baseball trials. He comes up to me and says, Coach Fritz, tell me about this guy. And I said, there's not a better kid. You want him on your team? I said, I don't even know if he can play baseball, but you want him on your team because he's going to give it everything he's got. And 110% award, Dakota Begley. And then our academic award, Coach said we don't have smart guys, but we have one right now that has a 4.2 GPA, and that's impressive considering he does cross country, he plays basketball, and he's always working, always. I can remember we had a short practice one day, and it was warm outside one day this winter, and I had to go to my room and do something after our short practice, and I come back, and Grant's sweating like crazy. And I said, Grant, what are you doing? He said, I just ran for a three-mile run. I just went for a three-mile run. And I'm like, Grant, you don't need to do that. And he's like, I need to get a run in. So not only does he work hard outside of the class, but he really, really works hard in the classroom. 4.2 GPA, Grant Brockman. That was our freshman team, and my goal as a freshman coach, yeah, we want to win basketball games, but more than anything, I got to have these kids ready for JV and varsity practice next year. And I can honestly say with their work ethic, I have no concerns about them next year in the JV and varsity practice. You upperclassmen, they're going to bring it to you every single day, and they're going to work as hard as anybody, and that's why it was so enjoyable for me this year. Thank you, guys.
Coming down to the end of the ceremony, but we do have, as you always do, a lot of seniors. You know, winning teams, winning programs, it all comes down to senior leadership, and there's no shortage of seniors between the basketball team and the cheer squad. So a lot of seniors to thank for their leadership here tonight.
Senior video. Brad, you can go ahead. The senior. We're going as fast as we can, you all. This special year, so bear with us here.
On times we had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came so far and know that.
My world.
pieces, but now I'm rising from the ashes, finding my wings. Know that I need it, was there all along, within my reach, as close as the beat of my
MCS TV's coverage of the 2013 Men's Basketball Awards Banquet. We'll continue in a moment. Sponsored by Richmond Car and Truck Center, doing business the RCTC way, where quality and integrity are standard equipment. Located on Atwood Drive. State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble in Richmond. Luxury Pet Service in Richmond. Premier Rehab, right here in Richmond. Renfro's Paint and Collision in Richmond and Berea. Davenport Custom Guitars, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, Richmond Tourism, First Gear, Row Signs, Berea Online, and WKYT.com. Another great sponsor for Madison County School Sports Television is Madison HVAC. Visit them at MadisonHVACR.com.
All right, my 8 seniors and Gavin too, 9 seniors, would y'all come forward here and go ahead and get your girls too,
yes.
Your 3 senior cheerleaders. With my guys, we've got a special collage frame pictures here for you all. And of course, don't forget your banners over here on the wall. And just stay up here for a second. I don't know what all the girls have.
Probably more.
We have the same thing. What they're presenting them with, basically, guys, you can hold them up. On the top, it has a photograph of the state championship team with the cheerleaders in that picture. There is a picture of all of you on senior night. The picture at the bottom, Coach Feldhaus insisted it be in there. That's his idea. And then there's obviously an individual picture of all of you ladies. I know that you were excited to be a part of the state championship. You also have a memory book, and you need to thank your parents. Will my senior parents please stand? Please. I have Mindy and Jerry Goble. Mindy, have you done okay tonight? I have Renee and Jack Briley, and I have Diane and Ronnie Abrams. And they've been, I just want to say thanks for all the last 4 years of supporting these young ladies. They have a memory book, and your parents played a part in that as well. And then there's a small gift over there, a Pandora bag, okay? That's all I have. Thank you.
And I do want to say something. I didn't get to mention much about Zach and Chris. They didn't get to play a whole lot. It just so happens they're playing behind probably the two best guards in the state of Kentucky, but they definitely played a very big part in this senior class. Zach was more of our senior leader that would keep everybody loose. I think you could tell from the dancing in the video there. Chris was more of a serious leader, and I think he's one who really helped us after that Russell County game to have some good talks with not only the coaches but the players too. And I want to say the same thing that the Coach Fritz did. Don't let this be the highlight of your life. Use this as a catapult. Use this as a springboard to go on and do bigger and better things. But it's going to be very unusual walking into that gym in the fall when we have that first practice and not seeing you guys there. You've been a special part of the Madison Central family for a long time, and I just want you to know we love you, and you're always welcome back. So really appreciate this senior class.
And for my 3 senior girls, these 3 young ladies, in the 4 years they were in my program, they combined for 7 11th region titles. They were a part of our medium varsity state championship in 2010. They were all on that state championship team. Tori has 4 national titles. The other 2 leave with 2 under their belts. But beyond that, in closing, I want to say it's been an honor and a privilege to serve as your coach. And above and beyond, they've been such a blessing to my program because they represent what Madison Central cheerleading should be about. And they are the epitome of class. Thank you.
And for mine, before I let you sit, they won 95 games in 4 years. School single season record for wins, 32. 4 district championships. 1 regional quarterfinalist, 1 regional semifinalist, 1 regional runner-up, 1 regional championship, and 1 state championship. You set the bar very high.
I don't know if it's a bar that's attainable, but we've enjoyed the ride. So really appreciate you, seniors. Thanks.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. You may go first.
All right, yeah, y'all can get a seat. All right, real quick, we do have some special people that we have some gifts for, and we'll try to go through this as quick as possible. We've got our PA guy here with us today, Mark Smith, who did a very good job for us. Highlight tape, yeah, we got a highlight tape that we're going to give to Mark there. So, Brandon, he said, did Mark have to leave? All right, he had to leave. And our administrators, I think Elmer had to go, but I know we have Angie Barnes and Drew Muntz and Laura Dedek are all here, and we have something special for them. Give them a round of applause. Very supportive administration. I think my favorite part of the highlight tape was watching Drew standing there by Mr. Barton giving that pump fist every time we'd score, making one of those comebacks. Chris and Brandy Anderson helped us out a lot of times, helped drive the bus, helped do the computer coach when Anthony couldn't be there, the book when Don Bob couldn't be there. So we have a special picture for you all. Chris and Brandy Anderson. Brandon mentioned a couple of our fans, faithful fans that were always there and traveled, seems like wherever we went. So we have something special for Dean Reed and John Hancock. I think they're both there. Also, two of our biggest fans, Jim and Debbie Hackworth. We have something for them, always there. Okay. Two people that were very instrumental in getting Karen and I here when we first started Madison Central 20 years ago. The guy that was principal at Madison Central then, Mr. Raymond Ross, and Ron Eden. So I have something special for both of them. I think they were very excited with this year's victory. So really want to thank them. I do want to have also a special picture for one of our seniors on last year's team who didn't miss very many. He was at a lot of practices this year, one of the most supportive ex-players I've ever had, and that's why I invited him to sit on that bench during the state tournament because I wanted him to enjoy this ride also. So I really appreciate having Kyle Congleton with us. Had a couple volunteer coaches this year. Zach Irvin, who was a student here at Eastern, would help out and come to practice whenever he could. And Tashad Myers, who's been with us the last two or three years, who lives in Louisville now, but he would still drive back and make as many games as possible. So I have something special for both of them. Also want to thank our trainer and student trainer, Cassie Cavanaugh and Caleb Maddox. So they got to enjoy the ride with us at the state tournament, so we have something special for them. Cassie interviewed for a job back home in Iowa. We were kind of glad when she told us she didn't get it because we don't want to lose her. It was their loss and our gain, so we love Cassie and glad she's going to be back with us. The big one there. Yes. Our bookkeeper, Brandon's already talked about Don Barker. I think he's kind of been I've kind of been a father to some of these, Don Bob grandfather to some of these guys. So I have a special framed dream picture for Don Barker, our bookkeeper. And those are really nice. Our computer coach, Anthony Hendricks, second to none when it comes to working that computer and doing our stats, have something special for him. A little framed dream picture. My pastor, Virgil Grant, and what was amazing, as soon as we won that 11th region tournament, of course, you lose money when you go to the state tournament, let's be honest. He had every single meal covered, people to cover the meals, and we ate good, didn't we, guys? We ate really good. So Virgil did a lot for this basketball team, did a lot for me personally, so I have something special for Virgil there.
And also Dr. Palmer, he was very instrumental in a lot of things with this basketball team. Also helped out paying for a lot of meals during the state tournament. Of course, he's Coach Cal's dentist, and I think one of the main reasons Coach Cal got interested in Dominique, because every time he'd come to Doc's office, he wouldn't leave him alone. It was Dominique Hawkins this, Dominique Hawkins that. So finally, he just gave in, so I need to recruit this kid. So, Doc Palmer. And I really appreciate Sean and what he's done for us. He kind of took over with the Indian Insanity where we started our year, and kind of hosted that and emceed that for us, and he's done a great job here at the banquet. So, Sean, we have a little special picture for you also. And the next person, I wanted to make sure I invited him to this year's banquet, because he's really the reason I'm doing what I'm doing, and that's my dad. And growing up in a coaching family, I knew at a very early age what I wanted to do. And go in that gym when I was 3 and 4 and 5 years old and watch him coach, and just to see the way that his players looked up to him. And he was just always the coach, and I knew that's what I wanted to do. And when I go home to Maysville, where I'm originally from and where Dad lives, he's still the coach. I mean, that's what everybody calls him, is the coach. So I just hope I can be, maybe when I go home, maybe be called the little coach. But I really appreciate everything that Dad's done for me, and I've looked up to him for a long time. So I have something special for him also. Of course, Coach Rob and Coach Fritz have been with me for a long time, so both of them are going to get one of those big dream pictures, and also the collage picture, and I really appreciate all their support throughout the years and putting up with me. So, I don't know. All right, Karen's got a couple.
My list is much shorter, I promise, and I just want to say thanks for enduring. I know this is long, but, you know, we have a lot of terrific things going on at Madison Central, and I hope that you've enjoyed this evening. Last but not least, we have two people that we don't want to forget, because they take special care of your girls. They're a blessing to me, and they get us there safely and get us back, but they've just become a part of our cheer family, and that's Mr. and Mrs. Middleton. They have a frame print. So, Mandy Spring. I also want to thank two people that, you know, probably get overlooked quite often. They were cheer parents for me long, long ago with this young lady. And when I brought her back on as an assistant coach, they just kind of stepped back into their old role. And so, Pat just does the cheerleading fundraising like she has a daughter in the program. She does, but her daughter is the coach. And I've said, you don't have to sell poinsettias. You don't have to sell cookie dough. She'll say, somebody will need the help. Just apply it wherever you need it. Our printer was down last week. All of your certificates, all of your things were done at Adams Pontiac. He's been our electrician. Mandy complained about the dark. He helps us out in the cheer gym. So I want to thank Mr. and Mrs. Spicer for their gift of Mandy, but for all the things that you do for the program. So we have a small token for you as well. Pat and Jerry Spicer. I think I said that right. And then lastly, Greg, I promised you we couldn't put your hand on your gift. You're going to get a copy of this DVD to take home. So I know you were at every game, and I know you're going to be at a lot more in the future. So welcome aboard. Okay.
And before Sean wraps this up, I do want to remind you about the pictures back here that Wade Upchurch, he's drove from Monticello to show those things. So, and there's some, that last second shot by Kenja, that picture is unbelievable. So, and I think what he's doing, he's just taking orders and getting your address and phone number. He'll send the pictures to me, and then you really don't have to pay until they come in. But he'll take your orders there. Rachel's back here in the back table, and we've got quite a few of the highlight tapes we can go ahead and sell if we run out. She'll take your name, and I'll get them quickly. And the highlight tapes are $20. What else, Coach? Anything else? Girls? Oh, and unbelievable. If you'll check those case, those commemorative case knives that have Madison Central 2013 state champions back there, they're really nice. And all of our 15 that dressed got one of those with their number on it. And they're on sale at Ace Hardware too, right? All right, girls, y'all ready?
They would pick the short one to talk. We have a gift for our coaches, and we want to thank them for everything they've done for us for the past 4 years. They've definitely taught us basically everything we need to know about life. They've taught us how to get through the rough days, how to celebrate the good days, and how to take every friend along for the ride. And we want to say thank you very much.
Is there anybody else before Sean wraps us up? All right, Sean.
Well, just want to thank everyone again, especially Virgil Grant and Eastside Community Church. I forgot to mention this earlier. Not only did they prep all the food, do all the decorations, they actually had a church service in here, you know, about 2.5 hours before this started. So they literally transformed it. So just a great job. Coach, one more thing for you I wanted to mention. I know you're a little upset about losing to your brother this year. If he says anything, maybe just point to the trophy. That may do the stage. And most importantly, I wanted to say thank you to these athletes right here in the middle. You know, you guys talked a lot about it in the video, about what it meant to Richmond, and it meant the world. And hopefully we were able to show you that by coming out en masse at the parade and really supporting you guys, because you guys changed Richmond for the better, and we certainly appreciate that. But a little more work to be done still. You've got another appearance to make. They've got some championship rings to collect here on May 18th at Telford YMCA. They've arranged to get championship rings for everyone, so that's obviously a big deal. But this team was all about selfless behavior. And, you know, I'm, as an outsider, kind of an outsider looking in, you saw it not only with the cheerleaders, with the players, with the coaching staff. You know, they talked about the guys knowing their role, and it goes down to even little things. I think back to the championship game at Rupp, cutting down the nets, Coach Fritz standing at the bottom of that ladder, making sure that Coach Feldhaus is the one that cut that last strand of the net. I mean, it just, throughout the whole program, on the basketball side and the cheer side, it's selfless. They just know how to do it. But just one final time, if you would, there's a ton of hardware down here on this stage. This is all from this year. So if you would, one more huge round of applause for the cheer squad and the basketball team. Thank you, guys. More hardware to win next year. More hardware to win next year.
Thanks for watching this edition of the 2013 Men's Basketball Awards Ceremony. Sponsored by Richmond Car and Truck Center, doing business the RCTC way, where quality and integrity are standard equipment, located on Atwood Drive. State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble in Richmond. Luxury Pet Service in Richmond. Premier Rehab, right here in Richmond. Renfro's Paint and Collision in Richmond and Berea. Davenport Custom Guitars, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, Richmond Tourism, First Gear, Row Signs, Berea Online, and WKYT.com. Another great sponsor for Madison County School Sports Television is Madison HVAC. Visit them at MadisonHVACR.com. Have you suffered an injury? Are you playing with pain that prevents you from playing your best? Let the local team of professionals help you get back on the playing field. Our team consists of physical therapists with over 10 years of experience treating sports injuries. Many times an injury on the field or court occurs without having control of the situation. One of the most important decisions after an injury is to decide where to complete your rehabilitation. The therapists at Premier Rehab have worked with professional athletes from the NFL and Major League Baseball. So take control of your injury and choose Premier Rehab. At Premier Rehab, you will gain the advantage over your competition. Take the home field advantage and team up with Premier Rehab. Want to know school sports in Madison County? Then you need to visit MadisonCountySchoolSports.com. Everything sports in Madison County. That's MadisonCountySchoolSports.com. Visit us now.
Make the most of your trip to the Red River Gorge in Kentucky with scenic cabin rentals or delight in the mountainside beauty of the Daniel Boone National Forest. Whether you are planning a long vacation or just looking for a few days away from it all, check out sceniccabin.com. Our rental cabins and lodge are located close to the Red River Gorge and Natural Bridge Resort State Park. Family reunions, corporate retreats, weddings, and other large groups are very welcome. Cabins are available for small groups of 2 to 6 or large groups up to 15. All of our cabins are modern with city water, satellite TV, paved roads, full-service kitchens, modern bathrooms and showers, decks, grills, and outdoor fire pits. Many have hot tubs and game rooms or gaming tables like pool or ping pong, foosball, and air hockey. A few have internet. Visit sceniccabin.com online or check us out on our Facebook page. sceniccabin.com. Shouldn't you start planning that relaxing mountain getaway now?